So how do you true your faith with science? Do you see there being any conflict? And how would you explain something like that to someone who feels that there is that sort of disconnect with their faith?
I actually personally don't feel like there's any conflict at all. In terms of the values of our faith, we, just about everybody who says they're a Christian, would agree that God created the earth in some way, shape, or form and gave it to humans to take care of.
Stewardship.
Exactly. And then we all agree on the greatest commandment, which is to love your God and love your neighbor. And so today, if we look around, we can actually see how our neighbors are being harmed by climate change. And the loving response to that is not to bury our head in the sand and say, oh, it's not a problem. The loving response is to, you know, pull up our socks and say, here's some things we can do about it. It wasn't until after I got married that my husband and I figured out that he didn't think climate change was real. He was coming from growing up in a community where he just heard all the time it was a liberal hoax. So it took us about 2 years to actually kind of figure it out ourselves.
And what was that like? I mean, what were those pillow talk debates like?
Yeah. So he's thinking, here's this person I married. We're both Christians. We both have similar faith, but she believes completely differently on this issue than I do. And then, in addition to being a linguist, he's also a pastor.
Your husband's a pastor.
Yeah. So he had questions like, you know, if God is in control, how could this be happening? And so what I've learned is that there's a lot of common questions that we need answered before we can move past them. And not thinking that any questions or concerns or debates that people have about climate change are stupid.
Right.
What really decided him, and he would tell you this if you asked, is when we went to NASA's website and he downloaded global temperature data into his own computer, put it in Excel, plotted the graph, and looked at it. And he said at that point, he had a decision to make. Either all of NASA was somehow involved in this massive cover-up.
Liberal.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Or global temperature was actually increasing.
Right.
And for him, that was kind of the turning point. But the root of the issue is that we feel like the solutions to climate change challenge many of our fundamental beliefs. Like, if you think about the solutions to climate change that people have been talking about so far, you hear words like taxation, government control, restrictions, limitations, or basically all of the kind of hot button issues. So I feel like there's kind of this innate opposition to the type of solutions that we've heard.
So how do you start untying that knot? How do you start showing that this issue is not about red and blue? This issue is about all of us on this big ball that we can't escape.
Well, as humans living on this planet, we just have so much in common with each other that I know that we can find ways to move forward. So we have to start with the facts. We have to start with the data. And then I have to, like, take off my scientist hat, which is hard because we're trained never to do that.
That's right.
You have to take off your scientist hat and you have to say, okay, I'm a human being just like you. Here's what's important to me. You know, I care about my faith. I care about my family. I obviously want a healthy economy and a good job. Who doesn't want that? So let me tell you about how climate change is actually going to affect those things that we care about.
Right.
Why not?
So these solutions need to be tied into, and I think we see that over and over again, your own interests. If you can somehow find a way that it supports your values, your desires, the ways that you want to live your life, then now we're not arguing about is the science real or not. We're saying, is this something that's mutually beneficial to the people I care about and myself, my family, my friends, and my community?
Exactly. Even when you look around West Texas, what's really cool is we are already doing a lot about it.
In what ways?
There are wind farms going up like crazy all over farmers' land. They're not putting up wind farms because they're, you know, tree huggers.
Right.
They're putting them up because they make sense.
Right.
They have 1,000 new jobs. The economy is completely revitalized.
Right.
And so it's an economic issue that's investing in people and in the community, but at the same time, it's producing green energy.
Right.
It's interesting. If you look at where all the wind power is in this country, it's all red states. So often my conclusion is, you know what? The bottom line is, even if you think climate change is still a complete crock, look at all the side effects of reducing our dependence on fossil fuels, reducing our coal and gas and oil, and investing in renewable energy. These are the terrible side effects.
Yeah.
We would have cleaner air.
Right.
And anybody who has a kid who has asthma knows how important that is.
Exactly.
We would be investing in our local economies because that's where we grow the clean energy. So it's not about, you know, imposing taxes and limitations on ourselves. It's about looking around for what's the next opportunity that we can invest ourselves in, that we can invest our time and our effort and our jobs in, that will sustain us.
Absolutely.
Yeah.